human spaceflight. Two words that, when combined, captivate our imagination and inspire us to explore worlds outside of our home planet.
We keep pushing the boundaries of what's possible because we're evolving, we're growing, we're learning. We, as a human race, have always done that, and we should continue to do that.
For more than a decade, NASA's groundbreaking Commercial Crew program has led the way toward a new era in human spaceflight, impacting the agency and industry in tremendous ways.
Thank you so much for what you've done for us today, putting America back into low Earth orbit from the Florida coast.
First, by partnering with innovative commercial partners to return a human launch capability to the United States and reestablish the nation as a leader in exploration.
We definitely really appreciate the hard work that you all had to go through to ensure that the contractors could understand NASA and what we needed to have human spaceflight be safe in the way that we wanted to operate it.
Then, building on that developmental success with reliable transportation services to the International Space Station that strengthened our international partnerships.
Four new members, bringing the total Expedition 64 crew to a total of seven.
Enabling more science on orbit.
Boeing Starliner spacecraft completes its historic first docking to the International Space Station, opening a new avenue of access for crews to the orbiting laboratory.
Lowering costs and increasing returns on our nation's investment.
The availability of extra crew members going up on commercial crew has been a significant advantage. We've doubled the amount of time that's available for crew to conduct science.
We're touching down in the desert of New Mexico, marking the completion of Orbital Flight Test 2.
NASA's Commercial Crew program has proven an innovative commercial model, paving the way for safe and successful private astronaut missions.
It is enabling this more privatization of the space world as well. And I think that's something that the Commercial Crew program should be proud of as well, because you are enabling that to happen.
And future commercial space destinations.
So we both benefit. I think that's what's key with these partnerships. But we also benefit by seeing these commercial companies and how they do business. When we first started building the International Space Station, there wasn't any other space stations that we could use at that time, so NASA had to build it. But today, we can leverage private sector investment because there are other customers other than NASA who want to go to low Earth orbit.
With sustained crew transportation services to low Earth orbit, NASA and its international partners are further empowered to pursue human exploration goals back to the Moon and Mars.
We rise together, back to the Moon and beyond.
Building upon lessons learned and expanding the commercial model for applications in deep space. And it all starts in our celestial backyard. NASA's Commercial Crew program continues to be a cornerstone for the agency's long-term ambitions, providing crewed missions to station through 2030 with the potential to add new capabilities and systems as agency and industry needs evolve, and helping to keep crew safety at the forefront of our collective future.